Hello students, in the last class we have discussed about tissue culture and its advantages. In this class let us discuss about sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is a type of reproduction in which daughter organisms or young ones are produced by the formation and fusion of gametes. It's a type of reproduction. Sexual reproduction is a type of reproduction in which the formation of young ones takes place by the fusion of gametes. Whereas in case of asexual reproduction, there is no formation and no fusion of gametes, but in case of sexual type of reproduction, the formation of young ones takes place by the fusion of gametes. That means fusion of male and female gametes produced by the individual. And this sexual type of reproduction is biparental, means it involves two parents. Sexual type of reproduction is biparental, means involvement of two parents, means male and female. In case of both plants and animals, we can observe sexual type of reproduction. For example, bulls give rise to cows by sexual reproduction, and in the same way, other animals including human beings produces young ones by sexual reproduction, and it is a common method of reproduction in case of higher organisms or organisms with complex body design. And sexual type of reproduction is advanced or improved type of reproduction over asexual reproduction. Or compared to asexual type of reproduction, sexual reproduction is better one, because here sexual reproduction increases variations. It increases variations and it prevents overcrowding. Means by sexual reproduction, only few number of young ones are produced. Hence, it prevents overcrowding and it develops more variations in the young ones. Whereas in case of asexual reproduction, the young ones or the young individuals are produced mainly by the copying of the DNA. Young ones develop from the copying of DNA, or DNA copying, that is called DNA replication. But the copying of DNA develops only few variations. Whereas in case of sexual type of reproduction, formation of gametes and fusion of gametes takes place. Formation of gametes takes place by meiosis type of cell division. During meiosis, crossing over takes place, means exchange of genetic material takes place between non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosomes. Crossing over is nothing but exchange of genetic information between non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosomes. That crossing over, which occurs during meiosis, develops variations. And in case of sexual reproduction, variations of two individual combines. Variations which occurred in one individual combines with the variations which occurred in another individual. Means variations occurred by the male parent and variations occurred by the female parent combines and give rise to new combination of variants in young one or in daughter. Hence, the sexual mode of reproduction is better than asexual type of reproduction. Now, let us discuss the basic features of sexual reproduction. Basic features of sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is biparental. Basic feature of sexual reproduction is it is biparental, means involvement of two parents, involvement of male and female individual, and formation of gametes takes place by meiosis. By meiosis type of cell division, formation of male and female gamete takes place. Formation of gametes takes place by meiosis, and meiosis is a reductional cell division. Here, the diploid sex cells produces haploid gametes. For example, in case of males, the diploid sex cell present in the testis. Testis is the sex organ present in males. The diploid sex cells of the testis produces haploid sperm. In case of males, sperm is produced. It is the male gamete and the sperm is haploid. And in case of females, ovum or egg is the gamete, which is also haploid. Both sperm and ovum are produced by meiosis type of cell division. In some lower organisms, sexual reproduction takes place, but their sex organs are not well developed. Usually, these male and female gametes, in male and female gamete, one gamete is motile. For example, here, sperm is the motile, smaller gamete, whereas the ovum is non-motile, larger gamete. Sperm is the smaller, motile gamete. Motile means able to move. It is able to move, whereas the ovum is larger and non-motile gamete. Then, another characteristic feature of sexual reproduction is fertilization. Fertilization is nothing but the process of fusion of male and female gametes. Fertilization is nothing but fusion of male and female gamete. Fusion of male and female gamete is called as fertilization. And fusion of male and female gamete gives rise to zygote. Remember, here gametes are haploid. The male gamete is haploid, female gamete is also haploid. But the fusion of male and female gamete gives rise to diploid zygote. Diploid means in case of male gamete, one set of chromosomes are present, and in case of female gamete also, the presence of one set of chromosomes. That is called haploid condition. The fusion of male and female gamete gives rise to single-celled diploid zygote. Zygote is single-celled and it is diploid. That means here the presence of one set of male gamete and one set of female gamete. Zygote contains total two sets of chromosomes. Means one set of male chromosomes and one set of female chromosomes. Or one set of chromosome belongs to father and one set of chromosome belongs to mother. These are the important basic features of sexual reproduction. Later, here, after that fusion, zygote develops into young ones. Zygote repeatedly undergoes cell division and it gives rise to young ones. And in some organisms, egg, development of the egg takes place. Later that egg gives rise to young ones. They are called as oviparous. Egg-laying organisms, for example, birds, oviparous. Some organisms are oviparous. That means giving or egg-laying organisms. And human beings are viviparous. Viviparous means directly giving birth to young ones. Oviparous means egg-laying organisms. Viviparous means organisms which directly give birth to young ones. And sexual reproduction also leads to the development of variations. Variations is nothing but the degree by which an organism or an offspring differs from their parent. That means the morphological and physiological differences between the young ones and the parents. That is nothing but variation. Sexual reproduction develops variations. These are the important basic features of sexual reproduction. Now let us discuss about the significance of sexual reproduction. Significance. And under this sexual reproduction, we are going to discuss about the sexual reproduction in flowering plants and sexual reproduction in human beings. Significance or importance. Significance or importance of sexual reproduction. First one is, it develops variations. Sexual reproduction develops variations. Because sexual reproduction involves the fusion of male and female gamete, the fusion of male and female gamete develops variations. Or in the young one, smaller differences we can observe, morphological or physiological differences. Then another significance of sexual reproduction is, it develops better adaptability. Sexual reproduction develops better adaptability. It develops better adaptability. Means the organisms or the young ones which are produced by sexual reproduction has more adapting capacity. Means that young ones are survive in change in environmental conditions. We can observe better adaptations in case of young ones produced by the sexual reproduction. And sexual reproduction is also helpful for evolution. It is also helpful for evolution. Evolution is nothing but formation of new species. Accumulation of many variations develops or leads to the formation of new species. That is called as evolution. Evolution occurs due to the accumulation of variations. And that variation is mainly developed by the sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction also maintains vitality of the individual. It maintains vitality of the individuals. it maintains vitality of the individuals. So these are the some of the important significance of sexual reproduction. In the next class, let us discuss about sexual reproduction in flowering plants, means the structure of bisexual flower and what are the reproductive organs present in the bisexual flower. All these things let us discuss in next class. Thank you.